Okay, this is an overview for the Electra by Frank Miller and Bill Sienkiewicz Omnibus. There's the lovely red and white cover, which offsets the main Omnibus and Companion, which is red and black. This is thinner, but that's okay, because this is all the Miller Electra stuff, except for the stuff that's in the main Daredevil Omnibus and the Companion. So this is just the Electra solo stuff by Miller. And this collects Electra Assassin 1-8, Electra Lives Again, Bizarre Adventures 28, and What If 35. Get the cover off. Get those sexy red and white boards. Absolutely love these boards. This is probably, out of the three Miller, Daredevil and Electra books, this is my favourite looking book because of the red and white. Something about it just works so nicely. It's not the thickest book of all. This is the Daredevil by Miller Omnibus and this is Electra. So it's a lot thinner, but there's less content. And you know, that's fine. I don't mind thin Omnibus, as long as they're not split into two to make them thin. I'm looking at the Brubaker Omnis there. So there's your credits page, there's your contents. Starts with Bizarre Adventures. Man, I don't know who any of those people are except for Electra. That's interesting. Completely black and white. That's pretty cool. Then you get What If Electra Had Lived, which is obviously not what happened in the main Daredevil Omnibus. You get an introduction from Mary Jo Duffy and Frank Miller. And then this is Electra Assassin, which I think they said was an 8-part story. Yeah. Sienkiewicz again. God's sake, this art house style. Really not a fan. Because I think his talents are wasted. Like, if you look at these squarish drawings, and then you look at some of his other stuff, and I just think he's really, really wasted. This is better, but I'm still not keen on it. But then, you know, it was the 90s. This kind of thing was popular. Okay. Well, I don't know what else to say. It's him being 90s Sienkiewicz, I suppose. But I'm glad he grew out of it, because I really don't like this style. And I thought this style brought down Daredevil Love and War. And I'm really hoping the story in this is so phenomenal that it balances out the shitty art style. Because make no mistake, this art style was shitty in my opinion, but Sienkiewicz is an amazing artist when he does other types of styles. I'm not saying he's a shit artist, just that I don't like this style. Fucking hell. Vox Populi, voice of the people. If you've played Bioshock Infinite and you don't know why they're called the Vox Populi, it's because it means voice of the people in Latin. Sometimes Vox might mean truth. Pretty sure it's voice though. It's either voice of the people or truth of the people. That looks a hell of a lot like the Xenomorph. a fatter version. But it's got that black and grey, it's got the ridges. Definitely got the mouth, it's got that sloped forehead. Why is Elektra fighting Xenomorphs? This concerns me. I haven't read this yet. I've read the Daredevil Miller Companion. I'm reading the main Miller Daredevil Omnibus right now. I'm about halfway through that. And then I'm going to move on to this because... she does come back and become a part of Matt's life in some way or another again. I know she's in the Bendis Omnibus Volume 2, I think it is. Yeah, Volume 2. See. So she comes back, and I think reading all the Miller stuff before I read this stuff, when I get scenes like this, I mean, I understand it now, but I will have a greater appreciation for scenes like this because I'll understand the origins of why it's been included. So I do want to go through these first. So that's the end of it. And then you get all the covers. Designs. Ooh, extra bit there. More art by Sienkiewicz that I absolutely hate. Like, if he'd have done this book with the style that he did the Ultimate Marvel team-up story in, I think it would have looked incredible. Stuff like that. You know, proportions are right, but he's still just knocking it out the park there. And then I see this stuff, and I just think he's wasted himself on it. But he was so obsessed with this style in the 90s that this is what we got. And it's a shame, in my opinion. That's a very cool bit. And that's the end. So that's my overview of Elektra by Frank Miller and Bill Sienkiewicz Omnibus. Now there's a big gap between the Miller stuff, both Daredevil and Elektra, and this. And this is the start of Volume 2. See that? 0 to 15. And then Bendis goes on 16 to whatever it is, 58 I think. And then there's a whole run from Knights up to the end of Wade. And hopefully we'll get more Omnibus for after that. But I did just want to read the Elektra and Two Daredevils by Miller before I sank my teeth into them. So I had a good grounding for everything that happens. So I hope you enjoyed that overview. And I'll probably be doing Marvel Knights next.